Meaning friends, as a Dr. Hemant Patel, I am a general and advanced laparoscopic surgeon. Regarding hernia, we'll talk today. There are so many myths about this hernia disease or problem. We'll just clear out all the myths and facts we'll see regarding the hernia. So what is mean by hernia? As you see in the diagram, the hernia is an abnormal protrusion of a viscous or part of a viscous through a normal or abnormal opening in the sac it is containing the contents. So in general, you can see that these are various layers of the abdomen. This is part of the abdominal wall. So this is skin, subcutaneous fat, these are the muscles, this white line is peritoneum, and these are the intestines. Normally the intestines are protected from this, but wherever there is a gap in between the muscles or weakness into the abdominal wall, your intestine start coming out and you can see the bulge outside. So that is called as unnatural protrusion. So this is mean by hernia. So there are so many myths about the hernia that all the hernias are same. So no, there are so many types of hernias in the abdomen. So abdominal cavity is divided into so many places. So the front, it is called as ventral hernias, and the below bikini line is called as groin hernias. So depending upon the anatomical site, there is hernia called umbilical hernia, pediatric hernia, the lumbar hernia, spilarian hernia, inguinal hernia, and the femoral hernia. So various types of hernias are there. Every hernia is different. The treatment may be the same, that we put a mesh inside, but approach can be different, presentation can be different. So there are so many myths. One of the myths is that hernia is a disease of men, and another is that it is a problem of old age. No, it is a big myth that it is disease of men. Hernia can be seen from children to an old elderly female or male. There are few hernias which are common in children, that is called as the hernia seen in children is called as congenital hernias. They are present from birth. There are hernias which are more common in females. One of the hernia is called as femoral hernia, which is more common in females rather than males. But in general, hernias can be seen from any age and any gender. So we can see the various causes. Now there are so many myths about the causes also. We'll just see one by one. So normal coughing for 4 to 5 days in a flu or something will not cause a hernia. Two, hernia is caused if at all there is a persistent coughing. When you will get a persistent cough, if you are a chronic smoker, if you have got any type of chest problems like chronic asthma, COPD, then if at all you are doing a chronic coughing, then only it will lead to hernia. Normal simple coughing for 4-5 days will not cause hernia. So there is a myth regarding the cough also. Second thing, lifting heavy weights. Normal 5 kgs, 10 kgs routine weight, what we do in the daily activities will not cause hernia. Hernia is seen in laborers or the athletes who do wrestling or weightlifting. So chronic weightlifting or heavy weightlifting, which requires pressure to give into the abdomen, will preceded cause to hernia. There's another factor is obesity. Most of the people say that I got a fatty tummy, I may not have a hernia, but no, hernia is very common in obese because the fat is more, the muscle mass is less. The chances of recurrence of hernia is more in a fatty patients. There are some factors and hereditary. So there is something true about the genetic nature and the collagen disorders. If there are genetic disorders and there are collagen disorders, then you may have get to prone for hernia and the recurrence as well. There are other causes that which causes chronic intra-abdominal pressure rising. There are few patients who have got prostate problem, there are patients who have got urinary difficulties, there are patients who have got bladder outlet obstruction because of stricture. They will strain unknowingly over a period of years to pass the urine, which may precede for the hernia precursor. Chronic constipation is one of the associated cause, not a direct cause, but if patient is having chronic constipation, they two strain during defecation. They sit on the commode for hours together and unknowingly give pressure over a period of long many years may give rise to increased chances of hernia. So there is a myth also. I don't have any symptoms. I don't have any problem. Why I should go to a surgeon? I got hernia, but I don't want any surgery. If it is non-complicated hernia, how will you recognize hernia? You will feel some bulge at any particular point of the site of location. You may have some mild discomfort or a dragging pain depending upon the size of the hernia. But if these are asymptomatic, that doesn't mean you don't need a surgery. Anytime it becomes symptomatic, anytime it can become complicated, and then you may need a seek for a surgeon's help. So the people say, I have got since many years, when the patient comes in emergency, I ask always them, why you are not come earlier? They say, I don't have any problem. It comes and goes inside. You don't have to worry about. It has never given me any pain also. But when it becomes complicated, then there is no choice for seeking help of a surgeon. How will you recognize when your hernia is getting complicated? So if that reducible swelling, the swelling of hernia is normally reduces some lying down, when it increases some coughing. These are typical symptoms of hernia. But when it becomes irreducible, that means previously it was going down inside the abdominal cavity, now it is not going down. So that is called irreducible. So that is one of the signs that you should come to the doctor. When it becomes irreducible, the pain which was dragging or mild pain which becomes severe. In emergency situation, you get nausea, vomiting, abdominal distension, when the intestine stuck and doesn't go inside the abdomen. So this is called an obstructed hernia. If that part of intestine or part of bowel becomes gangrenous, that time it increases the septic chances and you may have a fever associated. So whenever there is an emergency, there are high chances of complication. Sometimes if the bowel is gangrenous, intestine is gangrenous, we may have to save the gangrenous part, do the surgery for the intestine rather than hernia surgery. So complications will always be there associated in an emergency situation. So mind well, hernia needs surgery. So there are people says, why you doctor, you can see the hernia, why you want to do any investigations? Why we need investigations? First thing, if at all we are suspecting hernia on other side, we may do a sonography for the contralateral point. We have to diagnose why this hernia came for that particular patient. Is there any chronic symptoms like prostate? Is there any pressure symptoms? Is there any abdominal pathology which increases the chances for hernia? That can be detected in a sonography. When patient comes in an emergency situation, we may have to do a CT scan. Why we need to do a CT scan? When there is a recurrent hernia, when there are incisional hernia. What is mean by incisional hernia? The hernia which is caused by previous scar or previous surgery at that site. So that time we know, come to know about the defect size, the contents, whether they are viable, is there any injury to that content because of constriction. So we came to know about these so many factors in the CT scan. So in complicated hernias, we do a CT scan to get all this information. Whenever the patient is not fit for a CT scan, then the creatinine is high, we may have to do an MRI for the soft tissue and other things. But by and large, sonography and a CT scan are the modalities to know the details of hernia and the complications. So people say there are so many hernias. You must have been come across in so many YouTube videos, so many Google people search on Google that hernia can be treated by medicines. Hernia can be treated by all other remedies, home remedies. So it can be treated with belt. So it is a big myth. Hernia will never be treated by this hernia removal teas, or there are home remedies for hernia and the belt. This is a big myth in the people's mind that hernia can be treated with all these modalities. No, it will never be treated by this. So don't fall prey for such treatments. So what is the right treatment for hernia? Surgery is the only option for any type of hernia whether it is a routine hernia, whether it is a complicated hernia. So you will ask me what type of surgeries. Surgery, there are two ways of surgery. One is open surgery and one is an laparoscopic surgery. What do we do in open surgery? We at the site of hernia, we cut down the incision, remove the layers, whatever the hernia sac is there, we push down the contents and we keep a neck there, that is called as mesh. Same surgery is replicated in a laparoscopic way, which we'll tell you in a bit of details. So there are myths about the surgery also. What are the myths? Surgery is extremely painful. It has got a long period of recovery. People say that doctor has advised me for 3 months rest. I have done a belt, I use a belt. I cannot go to the office early. So there are so many myths about the hernia surgery as well. Today is the era of laparoscopic surgery. You can see the laparoscopic surgery is known by minimal invasive surgery, minimal access surgery. Some people call it as laser surgery. There are names like keyhole surgery. There is name of laparoscopic surgery, buttonhole surgery. There are so many names of this laparoscopic surgery. What are the advantages of this laparoscopic surgery? We do these surgeries with tiny incisions. Maximum incision will be 10 to 12 mm. So 2 or 3 maximum ports will be used, a hand instrument 2 and one a camera port. So there are very minute incisions, less tissue trauma, less bleeding, and patient can walk in the same day, and next day most of the times they will go home in a routine hernia surgery. So the myths about the surgery that it is extremely painful with the advent of laparoscopy, it has gone away. Regarding the recovery of period, normally in routine laparoscopic hernia surgery, it is done under general anesthesia. Within 6 hours, 8 hours, patient walk around and by the next 24 hours, they can go home. So if at all anybody wants to join their work early, after 72 hours, they can move around everyone, they can do routine activities. So there is no long period associated with hernia surgery nowadays. And there is barely any pain. Most of the times we may not give a painkiller on discharge as well. So don't think of hernia surgery as painful. So myths about laparoscopic hernia treatment also. There are so many myths about the laparoscopic hernia surgery. Every patient is not fit for laparoscopic surgery. Myth is that everyone is eligible for laparoscopic surgery. No. Laparoscopy requires a general anesthesia. It requires fitness of that patient for general anesthesia. So anybody who has got compromised chest problems or a cardiac problems may not be fit for general anesthesia. Hence, they are not fit for laparoscopic surgery. And all the hernias can be treated with laparoscopic surgery. That is also a myth. I am a laparoscopic surgeon. That doesn't mean every hernia comes to me, I will treat by laparoscopy. It all depends upon the patient factor, it all depends upon the hernia factor, how big is the hernia, whether we can, it is an incisional hernia, whether there is a loss of domain, or whether any other major complication which needs to be tackled in the same situation, that will decide whether this patient is eligible for laparoscopic surgery or not. There is another myth about the surgery that hernia always recurs. So, it's not the truth. What is that the chances of recurrence in any surgery, either open or laparoscopy in groin hernia is 1-3%. And that also depends upon so many factors. If at all there are recurrent hernias or incisional hernias, ventral hernias, larger hernias, the chance of recurrence is 5-20%. So no hernia recurs as such. There are so many factors behind that. That may be chronic persistent cough, that may be chronic constipation, that may be urinary problems which is giving rise to pressure. So there are so many factors about this. Thank you. Thanks a lot. If any questions are there, my WhatsApp number is given. You can mail on my ID. Any type of hernia queries regarding problems, symptoms, surgery, you can get back to me. Thank you.